So I've got three pots here, or three pieces that I could probably trim. They feel leather hardish. This one does. And they all feel pretty close. I think I could, but I'm a little intimidated by that right now. You know, I was all like, trimming's my favorite. But now, like, I'm sitting here, I'm like, shit. I don't know. But I still have two balls from yesterday that I didn't throw. So I got those to work on. Difference in my setup is that I have the dogs in here today because Sean's napping, and God forbid they be in a room or house without humans where they can see them. So chances are at some point one of them is gonna knock the camera, but that's okay. We're not gonna eat clay, right, Opal? And anyways, so my plan is to start with throwing because that just makes me feel more comfortable. And depending on how I feel after I throw, if I've built up my confidence or not, whether or not I will try to trim these. Otherwise, what I may do is just keep them covered for one more day and watch some videos on trimming. But I don't know if I've actually got another day. Well, I mean, I know I can just almost sand at it. I've been in that situation before where they're just too dry. And it's not like I'm keeping it anyway, right? So, yeah. Oh, and I even brought my little, I made this. This is my little marker with my initials on it. I probably should be dating them too, but like I said, I'm cutting them up and trashing them. It's really funny. I was all like, oh, I'm not gonna keep any of the pieces until I feel good about them. I guess I underestimated what it would take for me to feel good about a piece. Like, there's a sense of accomplishment in like each of these. This is the one, this is the oldest one, I guess. This is the one the first piece that I was able to throw. I did this on day two on the wheel. Day one, I didn't get any pieces to keep. And then these two I did on day three. I did this one first, which this one's probably my best of the three. And but this one is my tallest, well, at least almost my tallest. This one is taller, so I don't know why I kept this one. Probably shouldn't have. But anyways, I need to. I want to get the practice of also reclaiming. This is I've had 3 days off of the now 4 days off of the same 5 pounds. I'll actually take that back because I cut more pieces because these are. Also, these are new pieces that I cut off. So God knows how much I've actually gone through. But I also thought maybe I should be weighing them after to see, like, after they dry, like weigh them when I pull them off and weigh them after to see how much they weigh, to see, like, how much clay actually makes it from one step to the next. Because there's like a shit ton of clay that ends off at slips, shit ton that ends up on the wheel and on my hands. So yeah, it's going well though. I'm really happy with what I've done so far. It makes me feel good. Like, I want to get on here and get done and, wrap up work so I can come in here and play. Yeah, I think I really underestimated how quickly I would want to start firing pieces. But I just gotta remember this is like, an exercise in non-attachment. Like, yeah, it's great to have them, it's nice to look at, but it's all ego. That's nothing but ego right there, me wanting to show myself like what I did. So I should let go of that. So yeah. I got my pieces from yesterday. I didn't really look anything up. More elevated seat. I do wish I was up somewhere where my knees were above the wheel. But in order to do that, I would need to elevate my seat more and then have something for my feet to be on, like cinder blocks or something. So because what I end up doing is I try to keep on my knees, but I still end up hitting my arm on the splash pan and causing bruises. Things I thought about is get some kind of air filter in here because my eyes are fucking up and I'm just assuming that it's sitting out here because I can see all the stuff fly around. I used eye drops before I sat down, so hopefully that'll help. And I've got eye drops in my pocket. I hope future me. I hope this. Doctors, what they say, it just eventually burns itself out. I'm curious. Is it me who actually ends up watching this? If that ever happens. Could be worse. At least I know when it's happening and I can get ahead of it. Again, these should be about 1.5 pounds. Some other things that I did yesterday, I really focused on staying out of this whole noon, 6 to noon space. And I did notice I had less play. Gator bait. He's blind and he's just like, he's not blind all the way, but he's pretty damn blind. And he's just wandering into shit. I got him a pillow to lay on, but anywho. Hobo, don't eat leaves. You guys can go inside, you don't have to be out here. Garen wants to be inside, he doesn't like it out here, I know him. Anyways, so I did notice when I did that, focused on keeping my hand, my left hand on this side. I didn't get as much slip to slip off my hand. I still can't find like comfortable position for me to use my hands that way. I still feel like if I switched, it would make more sense. But I think what I'm gonna do is just get to the point where I'm okay-ish, going counterclockwise, and then maybe try to switch clockwise, just because that's what everyone says to do. And so before I start, I don't know, it's like, the way I try to do things, I learn something new. Find people who've done it more than me, copy them, and when I've gotten it their way, if I'm still not happy, then start experimenting, but I just found that things go a little more quicker in learning that way rather than me trying to like forge ahead and do it my own way from the get-go. So anyway. The other thing I do differently than we did at the studio is like I use like straight up slip instead of water. I did see a video where someone said somewhere that's a good way to use, but I wonder if I shouldn't be using more watery slip. I don't know. We'll see. Like, it doesn't really like slide around and stuff. The slip, like, it doesn't slide around the clay. Oh yeah, the other thing I gotta work on is like finding a speed and just sticking to it. I think if I had known like art school was a legit option, like that was something that people actually did, it wasn't just some like thing you saw people do on movies and stuff, I think I would have tried it. I definitely find more satisfaction in making something and creating something than managing. I mean, managing is cool, like when you get a team and you like build someone up and, you know, help someone feel like, oh, you know, make them feel good, or you accomplish goals and stuff as a team, but like, that's the parts that I like. Unfortunately, that's not always the job. And rarely is it the point of the job, even if you're managing. Usually the point of the job from perspective of your boss is revenue based. So right now I'm trying to get it more into a, I had it like flattened out into a wide shape. Now I'm trying to like push it into more of a cone while keeping the, trying to keep the top from having a divot. Trying to play with too is like, oh, am I pushing too hard? Is that why clay comes off? Do I need to just push less? Am I being impatient? I also thought I should probably set some goals. Like, what am I trying to do? Like, right now, I'm just still learning, you know, hey, what does what? Like, kind of getting a sense of everything. But I think to get even more of a sense, I need to start, like, trying to do things. Like, okay, like, right now I'm getting, like, you know, where to put my hands. out, you slip. And I'm sure that changes with like what you're trying to make, you know? I started earlier today. I don't know what time I started because I didn't look. I told Sean we need a clock in here. Maybe I'll hand build a clock. But, so I can learn how long everything takes me, like when do I start. I did figure out the clay that I have. I looked it up and I meant to write it down and say it is a cone 6. It's like a cone 4 through 6. It's like a medium brown clay, I think. Like one of the purposes of this, you know, future Casey, is to show you like you fucking know shit. And I think the only way for you to know, to realize that you know shit, is to like actually look and lay out, you know, how far you've come and all that you've learned. And your brain just doesn't hold it in that way. Your brain can be like, someone can be like, hey, what do you need to do about this? And I can say it. You know, but then if someone says, hey, what do you know about X? I'm like, I don't know anything about X. But then they say, hey, how do you do X with X? And then I'm like, oh, here are all the ways you can do X with X. And because of that, I always have like an imposter syndrome, doubting myself. You know, never do I see myself as the expert, no matter times, like how many times I have been the expert in the situation. You know, and I don't want to die feeling less than. Not saying I have to be an expert, but just appreciate, you know, myself and what I've done. Center and I can feel it.
know if I'm being really honest, you know, because this is just for me. I'm also treating this as like a therapy. See if that says something serious and fucking make a joke. So that must be what an air bubble looks like. See that shit? What do you do now? Huh? You see that shit? Huh? I don't know. Well, what the fuck? I don't know. Guess push it back down? I guess since this is a future case, you may not remember everything. So this is actually, this past 3 weeks is, you took a break from smoking the reefer for the first time in an incredibly long time. And what you learned is you weren't as good with shit as you thought. I just had, like, you know, been having mood swings. And it's been like 3 weeks, which. You know, it's the same kind of shit that usually triggers me. You know, any kind of sense of rejection. Things that may trigger bad memories. More than anything, it's been bad dreams. Or not even bad dreams, just intense dreams, man. I mean, compared to what they used to be, they're not like nightmares anymore, but there's always just a fear of something bad, you know? You know, and Sean, it was bad enough that Sean talked to you about it. Or talked to us, I don't know, talked to me. Which sucks, that brings out like a whole other fear of like, fucking something's wrong with me. You know, I'm just mad because I've been through a shit ton of therapy. And, you know, felt like I was good. You know, I'm in the healthiest relationship I've ever been in my life. We've been together 6.5 years, just celebrated 6.5 years. We rarely fight. I've never been so comfortable with somebody. You know, and we don't really have decent insurance right now. He suggested that, you know, I look at therapists, and I just, one, I didn't want to fucking pay for it, you know, he's like, we've got the money, It's like, I don't, that's not what I want to spend our money on. I've spent fucking enough money on therapy over the years. Do you know, when he said something that just like, again, sometimes it just punches you in the gut. You know, he was like, you know, what you talked about in your therapy, like how I described my therapy to him was how I talk through a lot of stuff. And he says that I do that now still. It's like I often say that I reason through things. And he's like, well, what about healing? Like, have you just healed? And I had to fucking Google what that meant. What does it mean to heal from trauma? Like, I don't fucking know. Talked about just about every fucking thing that ever happened to me in therapy. So I kind of feel like if I'm not healed, I should get a refund from all those therapists. Today instead of penises. Anyway, so I did Google, what does it mean to heal? How do you heal? And you know, I mean, like, I've done the thing, talking to the child that it was, like, I know shit wasn't my fault. And so anyway, what I read was techniques are yoga. Fucking certified teacher in yoga and have taught like god and godly amount of hours. You know? I don't really practice anymore, which, you know, maybe that's part of my problem. But then art. Art therapy was a thing, so I'm like, I'm fucking doing it. I am disappointed that I'm gonna go buy some pot this weekend and start smoking again, which I'm not like thrilled about. Like, it feels good to be at a point where like it would be purely like I could still smoke like if I had friends that smoked. I would totally smoke with them and not feel any different. I just don't want to get in the same point where I was before, where I got up and smoked and, you know, just, you know, heavy smoker. Gums are looking better, my sinuses are more open. I didn't really have a cough before. I'd occasionally cough, but not really. I don't really want to lose that. I feel good about that. But like, I can't handle these strains, man. Like, I haven't gone to the gym all week because I'm just fucking tired. Anyway, so yeah, as I was reading about like trauma therapy and how to heal and stuff like that, like there's like different techniques. Basically, it's like getting yourself out of that fight or flight mode. And one of the things, you know, that they recommended was medication. So I'm like, reefer's my medication. this will be my therapy. Thinking about switching to 2 pound block or balls after this, because like when I was wedging 3 pounds, it was like a little bit much for me, but 1 pound was too little. And then like just looking at the amount of shit that's coming off of here, you know, by the time I'm done with this 1 pound, I'm sure it gets, you know, whittled down to 0.5 pound. Gator, you don't have to freaking be in here. Do you want me to bring your hut in here? I can do that. I will move your hut in here. I'll stop what I'm doing for you, babe. Okay, I need light. I don't even know what the answer to this is.
There you go. There's your hat. It's right there, babe. Okay, it's on. So yeah, medium, but it's 30 minutes, 35 minutes so far. I'm still centering. I think this is the second time I've combed this lump, this lump. And my goal was to, like, those over there, I think I did like twice. I was gonna try to do three times. They say to use like your palms, the flat of your hand, and I totally see why, because when I use my fingers, I leave like ridges. It's just learning to get my hands down like that. I was thinking it'd be cool to actually apprentice with somebody. But gotta get to the point where I got something to offer first. Actually talking to myself and talking through shit. We'll see how much I actually open up, but just so he knows what I'm doing out here. When he hears me talking, maybe so, I don't think he ever would listen or eavesdrop because I don't think he's that type of person. Like, even, and I'm not saying like a negative thing, because people can eavesdrop out of love, you know, like a parent would eavesdrop on their child out of love kind of thing, not a, I mean, like, eavesdropping doesn't necessarily mean nosiness, you know? But no one's, you know, Sean's given a boundary. He's very respectful of it. You know, the other reason I'm doing this is to actually count how many hours I've spent doing this. One of the things that they have in yoga is like number of hours taught, and I never entered mine. I could go back and count. I know it was over 300 hours because I taught 5 days a week for like 2.5 years at the Montessori. So that alone would count if you don't count my time at the gym. You know, but I never figured those hours out, you know, and then after the fact, I never wanted to go count them up or whatever, but, and then I never counted my practice, like how many times I practiced and stuff like that, like how many times do you have to practice something to get good? Because I think that's like one of the things that people see in art, like I know I do, I see artists and I'm like, oh, you're just supposed to be naturally good at that, you know, which is fucking stupid. I know I should use my fingertips, but I really love seeing the lines. All right, so I'm gonna
Like, how many times has that not gone up and down twice? So go up and down one more time. But just look at all this clay that ends up outside, man. Like, I keep putting it in my slip thing, but I'm like, at what point, like, is it no longer slip? You know, but I'm trying not to have my hand right against the wheel, because that's like a beginner's mistake I read about. Somewhere in and weighing that, and that would tell me I'm just shaved off, which I'll do that with the next one. Well, fucking A. Fuck it. Just fuck it. I probably should just toss it at that point when I had that goddamn hole. Is this because, like, I didn't wedge it? I wedged it yesterday. Does that mean today's not good enough? I mean, it could have been that, well, no, I did cut that ball. There's that one ball that I cut in half yesterday and then tried to wedge it back together, so maybe that's what that was. I mean, I see a bump right there. Is that an air bubble? What is that? Seriously. Like, if I pop it.
That is like definitely gonna be my downfall. This is like not paying attention and then hitting something after. I am happy to realize that a lot of this shit on my neck is coming from me hitting myself rather than necessarily leaning all the way over and hitting the clay. Like, I should just let it go, but the more I fuck with it, the more I learn. Gator bait! Hey! That's enough. Don't chew yourself rotting. But pause aside, is like I'm pulling them up. Like one thing I notice is that when I pull up the walls, I have my fingers lined up. But like when I see people do it online, their fingers are like this, while mine are like this. You know? But when I try to do that, like this shit happens where like all of a sudden it goes wonky. So like, do I have the wrong one? Should it be the outside? Is, it's gonna end up scraping that off. All right, right now what I want to do is just like, can I shape the whole thing? Can I like bring it in, make it taller? I really want to make plant pots. I could feel like my fingers go dry before I even reach the top, so I guess I'm not moving fast enough. But then I feel like I'm moving up quicker than whole pot is turning. Yeah, I can feel part of that lip is thicker.
Seaver too. I'm just kind of fucking it up right now. Part of me's like, can you just like keep your finger and like just keep wearing it down until it like smooths, until it gets to the rest? Eventually close it.
I don't think I'm going to keep this one at all as far as something to trim, but I think I'm going to call it so I can do something else.
the shit that's closed, it's gonna close the slit. Try to stay out of your hair. Think I could talk you into something for me? Could you get a cup of water and pour some into my slip? Thank you. I brought the dogs in here because I figured they would just be absolutely inconsolable if you were in the bedroom with the door shut and I was in the garage with the door shut. So, like, in the class that I did with my sister, one of the days the teacher kind of like just challenged us to like see if we could close a form and make like a, you know, hollow form. And I don't even know if I tried. If I tried, I totally failed. My sister got it. So that's what I was trying to do. And I think I did it. I mean, pretty sure the shit's closed with like slip, but whatevs. The whole point is just to see what's possible, right? Thank you.
Hey, Sean. Can I show you something? Do you know what this is?
It's clay. You handled it.
It's hollow.
Nice. Seal it up. Hobo.
I just wanted somebody to see it before I took it off. And then like cut a thing off, but I'm gonna kill it anyway. It was a fucked up piece anyway. Like, but I just wanted to show it off.
Cool. I like it. It's very symmetrical.
We're gonna have to like set some kind of guidelines on what I'm allowed to like interrupt you to show you and stuff like that.
Mm.
Probably had to filter for the puppy photos.
Sure, yeah, yeah. Seems fun. This is something new that you've done.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool. Oh, I'm sore. My body is sore. Cool, cool, cool.
Neck. Ooh, it's got a soft bottom. Alright. I think I'm going to get a bag for that wet clay. I'm thinking about wedging that ball some to see if that wasn't part of the issue. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna stop video, wedge the ball. Get a bowl for this clay, throw that ball, and then I'm gonna, yeah, I'm gonna, you know, trim those.